The U.S. Air Force is outlining strategies to enable B-1B to carry more weapons, including hypersonic ones. The B-1B is a supersonic variable sweep wing heavy bomber used by the United States Air Force. It's commonly called the Bone. It's one of three strategic bombers in the U.S. Air Force fleet as of today, the other two being the B-2 Spirit stealth bomber and the B-52 Stratofortress. The U.S. has 100 of these. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes how U.S. Air Force plans to make B-1B more lethal. Let's get started. This video is sponsored by the free-to-play military vehicle combat game, War Thunder. We talk a lot about military vehicles on this channel, but what about trying them out for yourself? In War Thunder, you can choose from more than 1,200 playable vehicles from the 1930s to the 1990s and go to battle on more than 80 theaters of war. You can fly aircraft, helicopters, drive tanks, and command ships of all types and sizes, which have been carefully recreated from their real-world counterparts. It's available as a free download on PC, PlayStation 4, and Xbox One with cross-platform support. So grab your friends and give it a try. All viewers of Defense Updates that register using the link in the description below will also get a free premium tank, aircraft, or ship, and 3 days of premium account time as a bonus. The B-1A was originally designed during the 1970s as a high-altitude, Mach 2.0 capable nuclear bomber. However, President Jimmy Carter canceled the program on June 30, 1977, in favor of air-launched cruise missiles carried aboard the B-52, intercontinental ballistic missiles, and what eventually became the Northrop Grumman B-2 Spirit stealth bomber. This was done after it became apparent that penetrating Soviet airspace at high altitudes in a conventional non-stealthy aircraft was likely a suicidal endeavor. President Ronald Reagan eventually revived the Lancer program on October 2, 1981. However, the new B-1B was optimized for low-level penetration. Additionally, the aircraft was modified with new engine air intakes and other upgrades to reduce its radar cross-section. The resultant B-1B aircraft no longer possessed Mach 2 capability, topping out at roughly Mach 1.25, but had much better survivability because of stealthier profile. Most airplane wing designs are trade-offs. Wings are set for low-speed stability or high-speed performance, or some middle point. Even with flap systems and leading edge slats, fixed wings are compromises. A multi-role aircraft, like B-1B, needs more flexibility. Having variability in the wing configuration has distinct advantages in making a single aircraft adept at multiple missions. The B-1B is powered by four General Electric F-101 GE-102 afterburning turbofan engines. Each of these can generate 17,390 pound force, that's 77.4 kilonewtons of thrust, when operating normally, and 30,780 pound force, or 136.9 kilonewtons, with afterburner. These enable B-1B to have an excellent range of 5,900 miles, or 9,400 kilometers, and a service ceiling of 60,000 feet. The engine performance makes B-1B capable of hauling a lot of weapons. B-1B has a massive payload of 125,000 pounds, that's 56,700 kilograms, internal and external ordnance combined. It has 8 external hardpoints for 50,000 pounds, or 23,000 kilograms, of ordnance, and 3 internal bomb bays for 75,000 pounds, that's 34,000 kilograms, of ordnance. Depending on mission, B-1B can carry a variety of ammunitions, like Mark 84 general-purpose bombs, CBU-87-89, CBU-97 cluster bomb units, GBU-38 JDAM, AGM-158 joint air-to-surface standoff missile, JASSM, to name a few. At this point, there are two ways being looked into to enhance the weapon's carrying capacity. 1. The B-1B was designed with 8 external hardpoints to carry large nuclear-tipped cruise missiles. But these hardpoints were not put to much use. Due to START Treaty, B-1B lost its nuclear delivery role, and the cruise missile racks were removed completely. In recent times, one of the hardpoints was used to mount the Sniper Advanced Targeting Pod. So these unused external hardpoints could be used to enhance the weapons package. 2. B-1B has 3 internal weapons bays, of which the front two are connected by a common bulkhead that can be repositioned in order to create much larger continuous bay. The large carriage could be used to carry bulky hypersonic cruise missiles internally. Currently, B-52 Stratofortress is being positioned to carry hypersonic missile, which it can do externally only. So B-1B could be added to that role. To explain the concept, a demonstration was held. It was conducted at Edwards Air Force Base with the 419th Flight Test Squadron due to its experience with testing on the platform. The demonstration presented a hypersonic missile mock-up attached to a conventional rotary launcher, CRL. Viewers may note that this CRL is also used in B-52H. The CRL is basically a weapon-carrying and deployment system designed for the B-52 that enables it to carry a variety of munitions. It was made available to the B-52 fleet in 2017. For this purpose, the bomber was also outfitted with a mock joint air-to-surface standoff missile attached to a pylon. It was hooked to one of the original hardpoints on the plane. Lieutenant Colonel Dominic Ross, B-1B Program Element Monitor, said, "The purpose of the demonstration was to show that we're still able to move the bulkhead from the forward intermediate bay to the forward location, increasing the intermediate bay capacity from 180 inches to 269 inches. Additionally, we demonstrated that we can still carry weapons externally on 6 of the 8 hardpoints, which increases our overall carriage capacity." Ross added, "It increases the magazine capacity of the B-1B. Currently, we can carry 24 weapons internally. Now it can be increased to potentially 40 based on what type of pylon we would create. This gets the B-1B into the larger weapons, the 5,000 pounders. It gets us into the hypersonics game as well." He noted that expanded capabilities will be non-nuclear to keep the aircraft compliant with the new Strategic Arms Reduction Treaty, or New START. Captain Timothy Grace, Test Weapons Systems Officer, stated that the bulkhead modification can be accomplished and then reverted back. He explained, "It's not a permanent modification. It's something that can be done through a few work shifts with the maintenance flight. So depending on what the targets are that we're going after, the weapons we need to carry, we can move that bulkhead and do the external carriage." Colonel Richard Barksdale, 28th Operations Group Commander from Ellsworth Air Force Base, South Dakota, said, "It would basically increase the weapon's capacity to make the bomber more efficient, so that we're able to strike more targets with the same aircraft." Barksdale said, "It would allow us to more efficiently plan for targeting and use fewer aircraft with fewer air crews in harm's way to strike the same number of targets. It would also decrease the support required, whether that's tankers or other support assets." Barksdale stated that the added capability will be like having more arrows in the quiver of the B-1. Barksdale said, "It really shows the aircraft was originally designed for that capability, to move that bulkhead forward and make a larger bay. It shows the forethought of the original engineers, and now that can potentially come to fruition. To me, just the opportunity to increase the weapons load capacity is pretty exciting. It's a pretty impressive capability." Though B-1B is a relatively old platform, but the versatility of the design makes it relevant even today. Its enormous payload capacity and long range gives the U.S. Air Force tremendous operational flexibility. The U.S. Air Force is now developing the first prototype of the new B-21 Raider bomber. The B-21 Raider is envisaged to be a super stealthy bomber which will be able to penetrate the most sophisticated air defenses for decades into the future, and be able to take out high-value enemy targets without the rival even knowing it was there in the first place. Till the time B-21 Raider is fully operational and enough number of them gets deployed, the current bombers will have a role to play. It may also be that B-21 Raider will be assisted in combat by current crop of bombers. In this situation, enhancing the lethality of B-1B makes complete sense, and is a testimony to the out-of-box thinking capability of U.S. Air Force personnel.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.